Okay. Don't want to do a new game. Let's continue. Awaited decision. Dun, dun, dun. Okay. Wow, that was like loud.
That red battery will provide enough energy to enable the IDS device to widen the heavy dimension rifts in this area. Appears this dolly got stuck on an infinite loop. How unfortunate.
That one was easy. Breaking windows.
There seems to be a large expanse of piles and pits filled with various random objects.
All those socks the dryer's been stealing are there too.
No, not where you are. Here, in this confounded place. Are those hard candies? They're a little fussy. Ugh. Pleasant.
Stairway to Fluffy.
Nice job. No, not really. With the increased density and higher melting points of items in heavy dimension, quadrangle laser beams are rendered rather ineffectual.
I wanna rock! Oh, I wanna see what he looks like in Fluffy.
Like most things in life, timing is key.
Ah!
I came across Ike some time ago, and he decided to follow me back to the manor.
Thank you, Ike. Fluffy! I want to see what the cat looked like in Fluffy. That is cute. Very, very cute.
I believe Ike stole these and hid them at one point. He's rather fond of shiny objects. Not half bad.
But not half good either. Kitty.
This was once the family cat, Lord Widget Pompadour Fluffington IV, or Widget I. He somehow wound up in one of the Dolly cloning control units. I specifically constructed his monocle to fit him. Who knew it would be so impossible to find a cat-sized monocle? Preposterous. Sadly, Widget I has since passed on, but his memory is alive, somewhat. So I want to clarify that Dolly is great for cloning inanimate objects, but she's not entirely capable with organic ones. This is Widget's first generation clone. We named this one Colonel Fluffy McScratchers, or Widget II. Widget II is still mostly together and functional as a cat, but just a little wall-eyed. I just had to pass Widget II through Dolly again. I just couldn't resist. Definitely learned my lesson with this one. Technically, his name is Widget III, though he often responds to derp. I often find him walking around in circles while staring at his feet. Very friendly, but possesses the intelligence of a sack of rocks. Note that if you disrupt the blue beam, it should deactivate something.
He has a name tag.
Apparently, this unit needs a little bit of work. I'm not entirely sure how many BEDs of radiation that emits. Hope you're not looking to have children later.
So,
tell Ike, but that painting really unnerves me. He looks like a horrible mutant koala situation. I keep wanting to take it down, but he won't let me.
Okay. Ike it Mansfield Pulsar. What does this one say? Moby Dictromate. Funny. Moby Dick. He's it! Heart of Dark Matter.
This place is truly fascinating. That, combined with the fact that I have no clue how I was transported here, is certainly puzzling.
Stairs.
It's mostly dark. Well, maybe not dark. Sort of twilight.
Twilight, huh? You are at the end of time. Is this real life? Is this just fantasy? Bird! Just fantasy. Grab it. Ish. Really? I am not enjoying this. Okay. Let's see if this works. I did it. Just grab that one. I am through. Okay, thanks, Dolly. All right. Talk about heavy reading. Dang it. You have died. Thing number 456. You will never experience employing your first housekeeper.
It looks so cozy over there.
Not sure what that turned off, but hey.
I find the number 3 to be a very satisfying number. It's a Huebner number, and the proper amount of scoops on an ice cream cone.
Amen to that. Oh. Clever, 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 clever.
Could have done it better myself. Not bad, though.
Ice gun. More stairs.
Oh, I really wish I wouldn't do that.
Yeah. Springing to new heights. Okay. I love it.
This is a compression platform which uses photoelectric energy to function. Like a spring, the energy pulses below the platform excite the molecules in the air, stimulating an elastic structural rigidity. Careful. Didn't your parents teach you any manners? I was wondering where Ike put that.
We're hitting the wrong buttons. Perfect. Boom.
Yep.
that worked.
Not!
Sweatpants for 4 weeks straight. That's not a thing I care about. Calling in sick. Alright. Hold on a minute. Why didn't it work the first time?
Now I see a giant pit filled with keys.
Go to key house. Mind the gap.
Just remember, you need enough change in the mass to build up enough mechanical energy.
Yes, thank you. I know. Well, that didn't. Why didn't that work? Do I have to have it spit out more? No, I deleted it.
Think of this highly complex piece of technology as a trampoline. A double bounce could help.
Ah! Thanks for the tip.
It's time to spring into action. I crack myself up.
No. Freaking kidding me. Seriously. Oh, need to grab that first. Launch. Why isn't that working? Okay, maybe I'll stand on top of it. Okay. I don't get it this time, I'm gonna take a break. This will be a fun one to start on if I don't get it. Okay, at least I got that part down. That time. Get over.
Satisfying, isn't it?
Did it. Boom. That sound like a Wookiee again. Okay, we're gonna stop as soon as it gives me the next words. Wait, what does that book say? Call of the Wild Binomial.
This is one of my past inventions, Joan the Jetpack. Worked just fine, except I had some serious trouble with the hover-up feature. Somewhat flammable. Some might say incendiary.
Next.
You probably never saw this invention. It was my hole digger. We called it Every Day I'm Shoveling. And by we, I mean Ike. It was a little too efficient. This was the first and last time I saw it.
Around the world. Okay. Well, that was fun. Thank you.